Question 17. This is assessing your ability to use a calculator. So we have 8.4 times 3.7 divided by 5.3, add 1.8. Give your answer to 2 decimal places. So we need to remember to round as well. So when I'm typing this into the calculator, I need to remember that I put brackets around what's on the top and what's on the bottom. So we know that this line means divide. So if you're using the usual calculators we use in school, I would type bracket 8.4 times 3.7, close bracket. Just double check that you've written it correctly. 8.4 times 3.7, that's correct. We know this line means divided by, and then the bottom line I have to put, open bracket, 5.3, add 1.8. Close bracket. If you forget the brackets, then your answer may be incorrect. Double check you've written it correctly. And we have, and equals. So you should have this on your calculator then. So I can then round to 2 decimal places. So that means that after 4.377, so I need to put a line after the second number after the decimal place, and then I round as usual. So the number after is above 5, which means this number must round up. So that will be 4.38 to 2 decimal places. So if you had a 2-mark question, if you had this or 4.37, that would give you 1 mark, but then the full 2 marks would be awarded then for 4.38 because you've rounded correctly. If you're using a Casio calculator like I am here, you can actually input this differently into your calculator. So this is set out as a fraction. So you press the fraction button here, and then you'll see this symbol come up on your calculator. So the cursor is here, so that means you're inputting the numerator, the top number of the fraction. So again, I use brackets, 8.4 times 3.7, close bracket. And now I need to input the denominator, the bottom number of the fraction. So I press the arrow key. So the cursor is in the bottom part of the fraction, and I type it again. Open bracket, 5.3, add 1.8, close bracket. So this now looks exactly the same as it is on the test paper. So if I press equals, you'll see that it comes up as a fraction first. That's the setting my calculator is on, so I need to press this button here to change it to a decimal. And then this is the answer that we saw earlier. Just another way of doing it on a Casio calculator.